It's Saturday night, and in downtown Manhattan, punters at New York's hippest club, Mars, are rocking to a new beat, the house sound of Manchester. The city's latest and biggest export is a guy called Gerald, 22-year-old Gerald Simpson, who lives on a council estate in Hume. His first single, Voodoo Ray, cost him a mere 300 quid to record, has already sold 10,000 copies here, and is selling even faster on import in New York and Chicago.
Someone from Ram Records got in contact with me through listening to the radio, and says, well, just give us a tape of stuff that you've been doing. And it's a pretty old tape now, but at the time, it was my hottest tape at the moment, so I gave him a tape. It had Voodoo Ray on it. It had a couple of other tracks. It had a track called Schizophrenia. Everywhere I've been, people have been saying, oh, I like your record, it's really good. I went down to London the other day, they're saying, oh, you're gonna put the UK on the map again and all this.
These days, American producer DJs come over to Britain to pick up on new tracks, and they don't just check out the London club scene. Now they also head north to Manchester's Hacienda.
It's happening in the States, everywhere else. They're looking for a new style of music, which is what's happening here in England. A guy called Gerald is different. It's a different record, so it creates interest, and it's something that'll last just because it's different from anything that's out at the moment. It's really different. Tikoi has a certain style, all its own. And most of their music is not, you can't say it's house, it's more has a Latin flavor to it, you know what I mean? And nice music, just good music that any musician that hears it would say, wow, I can enjoy listening to this kind of music.
The Hacienda's DJ, Mike Pickering, is part of Tikoi, whose first single, Carino, was number one in the UK dance charts and was the first British house track to be released in the States, where it became a massive club hit.
And it's quite strange, actually. One of the things that's happened is that whereas we used to always, in the dance market, follow the Americans, the roles have been reversed, really. I think probably our ideas are a lot fresher than theirs because they're reworking a lot of old stuff, old ideas, whereas we're taking a lot of different... We're taking the American influences and European influences.
Mars DJ Mark Kamins agrees that this fresh new sound is giving British House its credibility on New York's dance floors.
With groups like Gerald and Tikoi, we're getting a real, sincere British House sound. So British House is just, again, an evolution of house music.
But the godfather of house, Frankie Knuckles, has his reservations.
I find it a little hard compared to what we do here. Every now and then, there are a couple of records that come out that are really, really nice. But for the most part, their sound, I find, is very hard. DJs like Mike Pickering, who's also a musician, pretty much like myself, we pretty much feed off of each other, We inspire each other to do different things, Once you get your hands wet as far as production is concerned, you got to go full force.
Obviously, it's very easy to put house tracks together. Well, it seems pretty easy. One of the problems nowadays is once you've got the track made, to make a track pretty cheap, especially with electronic gear, is now so accessible. And if you can't afford it, you can hire it. It's once the record's made, it's up till this summer anyway, it was very difficult to get a major company interested in a house track. I mean, if we'd have gone in February 87 with Carino, to a major company, they'd all after it. Now they all want it.
It's like an escape in a way, which has become an addiction. It's like some people take drugs, listen to music, play music, make music. I'm going to try and make a name for myself, here first, and then move on. So I don't think Hume's a very ambitious place to live.
Murder, mystery and suspense this week.